So I think all the different insights we looked at were all pretty interesting. I can already like pretty excited to try out some of these, right? Like maybe it makes sense for us to show pay later to younger consumers. Maybe we show it more prominently in the mobile because people already seem to be making their choice on mobile. But one question I've been having is when we implement some of these recommendations and show pay later to these consumers, how can we be sure that we are getting the right results because of these new rules that we are putting in? What it possibly do?
Some kind of simulation you want us to go? Is that what you're asking?
I think simulation is one way to think about it. Another thing I was thinking along the way was what we call as A/B testing in the industry, which is we want to test out any such concept like this, right? We use this method called A/B testing, where we try to see if this new method is more powerful than what we are doing currently. Maybe I can actually share some, a visual that explains the concept.
Do please do that. Please do that. I think we need to understand what this A/B testing is.
Sure.
So A and B, I mean, I presume there are two categories of people, A and B. You're trying to divide into two sets, huh? A and B, something like that.
Correct, correct. So this
Okay, I
A/B
see.
method is also known as test control method. So you'll see find these two words used. So it's all the same. Essentially, let's say you have a total bunch of consumers, your target population on which you want to test any particular idea. Here we're talking about marketing, but it could be something else as well, right? You want a total bunch of consumers. Now you want to test that whether this new idea is better or not. The right way to do it is not implement the new idea on everyone, but split them into two groups. You can call the two groups as A and B, or you can call them test and control, right?
I
The
see. Okay.
basic is that you expose only the test group to the new idea, to the new method, whereas the control group still continues in the same existing way.
Oh, that I, the symbol I which you have shown there means you're allowing them to see it. That's, I guess,
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
huh?
Yeah.
And that cross which you have put over there shows that you don't allow them to see it. They're
Don't
not
allow.
seeing it. They're
Yeah.
not seeing it. Okay, I see.
I
Okay.
mean, one example, maybe let's say somebody tells you that your website is all very dull. Okay. Yes, they tell you that why don't you try a new pink color for your entire
Okay.
website? Now, it's a very crazy idea, but maybe it'll work. You don't know. The only way to test this is you don't change the website to pink color for everyone. You change it to pink for this test group of people who will see the new pink color. The
Right.
old group of people are going to still see the old black and white website.
Okay.
Now, then what you're seeing, you need to, what is your ultimate intent? You have some objective. If people come to your website, you want them to maybe sign up, or maybe you want them to take a membership, something, right? You have some end objective.
Correct.
Now, you are going to measure whether this test group that was exposed to the new pink color website is behaving differently from the control group who did not see that website, correct? Who did not see the pink color. So you're looking at how much of these people sign up, let's say, for a membership, or how much of these people buy up the product that you want them to buy, anything, any intended action. You're measuring for the test group and control group and seeing at a per user level, is there a difference between the test population and control population? So that difference, and you measure what is the difference, the lift, as we call it. If there is a lift, and one more idea is important here, the lift should not just be a lift, it should be statistically significant lift, which means that the lift should be sizable enough compared to what you're measuring. You cannot put a small 0.01 lift on something that is of value and say I proved a lift, right? You'll have to, there are ways in which we can probably look at that later, but there are statistical tests which will tell you whether the lift is statistically significant or not. Once you know that, then that's when you conclude that, hey, I see that the test group which saw the new website pink color is statistically doing better than the control group which didn't see that. Therefore, I conclude that the new pink color is great. Now I'll go and change the website to pink color for everyone.
So it's important that this test group is carefully selected. No? You have to pick the test group carefully. Because if it should not be that the lift is occurring because of reasons other than this pink color. So you have to remove all the other reasons.
Oh, absolutely. Wonderful point. I think the very, very key criteria for doing this whole thing is to make sure that the test group and control group, before the start of the experiment, they are exactly alike. There is no difference between them. They must have similar people spread across similar age group, similar preferences. Everything should be the same for them. Now, during the experiment, the only difference that they are subject to should be this, in this case, the website color. Right? Then when you observe the difference in their output, you can correlate that 100% that this is due only due to that particular thing that you have changed and not due to anything else.
Very interesting.
We looked at this whole thing in the concept of website and all, but I think this is a very, very renowned concept. Like if you think about, you know, how people test new drugs, like new medications, new vaccines, everywhere this concept is used. Let's say when they come up with a new vaccine and they want to test it on 100 people, they won't give it typically to all the 100. They will give 90 people the vaccine and another 10 people will be given what we call as a placebo, which is nothing but some empty dummy medication. Then they will see if there is a difference between these two groups. I mean, is the treated or the tested group but performing better than that control group? So it's a very common way to measure the effectiveness of any new treatment or any new idea in general.
This is very interesting. GP, we should go and do this analysis and yes, come back and show it.
Yeah.
We will need to look at the data from multiple time periods, is it? How do we do this A-B testing? We first look at traditional data before we created the new method. And then we look at, or we do it in the same time period, but two groups. Is that, how do we do this?
So you have the current data of customers and their transaction behavior, all that we shared with you earlier, right? Where you draw the analysis insights. Now, taking that group, you need to divide your customers into two groups, the test group and the control group, making sure that they look very similar to each other. Like, let's say you compare their percentage of debit card transactions to the group one to group two, it should be similar. Percentage of credit card should be similar. Age, tenure, everything should be similar. So that way, you construct two groups. And then during the same period, you subject them to different treatment, right? One group, maybe you will use all the rules that you gathered earlier to show them pay later option only in a certain combination. For example, you said pay later is easier to use in mobile. Maybe you said pay later is easier for fashion. So for this one group, you will show pay later using all those rules in the right order. For the other group, you show it randomly. Then at the end of whatever period you're testing, if we see a difference between the behavior of these two groups, maybe one, like how do we measure the difference, right? Maybe we can say one group becomes, does more number of transactions than the other. Any metric, right? If we see a difference between them, then that concludes that these rules are very effective.
Okay. So you are testing within the same time period. It is not earlier time period versus new. It's within the same time period, test group versus control group.
Correct. That earlier time period, that's another method we call is pre-post testing, where we say before doing something, there was a certain, and then after pre and post, and we measure the difference. The problem with that method is that you can never be assured that change between the pre and the post is only due to this one factor, because there is a time. Maybe like people go through different experiences in their life. Maybe the economy is changing. Now, the data typically gets polluted when you move from one time period to another. So the right method to be testing is to do this in a single time period for two different but, you know, similar looking populations.
Fantastic. So, GV, shall we go do this calculation? We'll do analysis and come back to Venkat.
It should be fun to do. Yes, definitely. We should do it. Yeah.
Okay.